My name is Markus Tervo. I'm a magician and a mathematics student. Today I'm drinking coffee with Vice Dean Samuli Siltanen, the man, the myth, the legend. Nice to meet you.
Thank you, likewise.
I looked into your Twitter and it seems that you like landscaping and photography and especially of spiders.
I know it's an unusual hobby to photograph spiders. I've been photographing from 1980s, so it's really old and dear hobby of mine. And then, while photographing various small things, I thought maybe it would be nice to photograph some little monster, like a spider. It must be really scary. Once I managed to do it, I realized that they're beautiful. I mean, it's not a monster at all. They are feared much more than they really cause trouble.
Another thing people are afraid of, mathematics. Why? Why mathematics? What do you see in it? Why do you do it?
I have always enjoyed doing computations and solving problems. Another thing about mathematics, why it's nice, is that actually it's a really trustworthy friend. I mean, when there's a mathematical problem, there is a right answer and only one right answer.
Is there a truth to life? Please tell us. I want to know, is there something behind this?
I'm afraid life is more complicated than mathematics.
How do we get the younger generation to get passionate and to choose long mathematics?
I think it's important to tell people in understandable ways what is so fun and cool about mathematics. People use their smartphones for communicating, photography. It's mathematical processes and algorithms behind all of that.
Maybe the way to get young people to see this is by videos.
I think that's a really good way because mathematics comes to life when it's visualized. In every mathematical construction, there is a visual core that can be shown.
Why should I study? Why can't I just party all the time and live a hedonistic lifestyle?
I think learning something complicated and learning it thoroughly, it's a huge enjoyment. I'm all for parties as well, I mean that's great, but you can do both. I think it's a good combination.
How are you balanced? Do you think about this stuff 24/7?
There has to be something as well. Personally, I love to do weight training, so weightlifting and kettlebell
really?
Training. When having kilos on top of your head and squatting down, I mean, you have to concentrate on that.
That's a great balance of mathematics, spiders, weight training. How do you see the future?
It's cool to see where new technology is leading us, trips to Mars. And I think mankind will get serious about climate change and environmental problems. I'm kind of confident that we can solve those things, but there has to be a bit more awakening in the large sense in humanity. If people have a better idea, what all can we do? I think we have a lot of options how to go forward.
Does consciousness create the world?
This question goes to the metaphysics area. I don't think consciousness has been really defined. As a mathematician, it's so hard for me to answer this.
I'm curious if science can someday answer these questions. Why are we here? Where are we going? But do you think that that's a question that science can answer maybe in the long, distant future?
My gut instinct is no, but I don't know. I mean, science has provided really big surprises in the past, so maybe it will continue to do so.
The last segment of the interview, this is called a trick, joke, or puzzle. You have to show me and the viewers a trick, or tell a joke, or solve a puzzle.
I can tell a joke.
Brilliant.
There was a panda in a bar, eating a salad, but then suddenly the panda got up, started shooting around with two revolvers and then just went away. The customers were puzzled. what is this? But then the bartender just said, I just checked Wikipedia. Panda is a great bear-like animal. It eats shoots and leaves.
This was brilliant. Thanks a lot. Really, this was really fun. I had a blast. I hope you had a blast. If you want to learn more about images and mathematics, go watch Samun Tiedekanava.
All right, thanks guys.